Hello guys, welcome back to the next video. And in this video I will show you how you can create the filters. So we are in the edit mode, as you can see, and we have the different fields. And to create a filter we need to go into the charts, and over here we need to have this filter pane dragged over here. So once we drag it, it asks us what dimensions we want as our filters. So let's click on this and get some dimensions like customer segment. So here we have customer segment. Now if we want to add a couple of more filters, we can go back and click on, let's say if I go down and get order priority, and let's say I want to search, in this case maybe order mode, or oh, that was ship mode actually, I think ship mode, right? And maybe I want a product, so let's say I want product category. So all of these fields are here. So let's click on done and see how it is coming in the front end. So over here these fields are coming in order, so customer segment, order priority, ship mode and product category. And if you want, let me go into edit mode. If you want that these fields values are something you want to hide, but you want to only display the name of the field, so what you can do is just press the Control Z, because and just drag it up a little bit, and now you can see the values have been hidden and you just have the field names. And once you click on done, some of the fields are still coming, so let's go back and drag it. So now the values are not coming, but only the field name is coming. So if I click on customer segment and let's say I choose corporate and click it, here also you can see that how many selections I have made. Similarly over here you can clearly see how many selections I have been made. So this is another efficient way about how you can show the filters. One is definitely that you want to show the filter as well as some of its value. Another way is you just show the filter name and keep all its value hidden. One other thing is, let's say you do not want all of these filters in a horizontal row. So in that case, what you need to do is you need to keep creating the multiple filter pane. So for example, if I just go here, and if I want to remove, I can click delete. So yeah, that's another thing, that if you want to remove any filter value and want to replace with something else, delete it and add it again. So I will just go ahead and delete it. So now I will just drag it up until here. Yeah. And I will take another filter pane and I will add another dimension, maybe ship mode. Alright, it's did not select it, so ship mode, and I will press equals to, I think it should do that. And let me, yeah, we need the bracket when you have the space between the values. Apply, yeah, now it is coming fine. So you can still drag it, and if you want, you can keep it like this, or if I want to show the value, you will drag these borders down and it will keep showing you the value. So let's click on done. So in this case, customer segment is not showing any value because we have dragged it up till here. But for ship mode, you can see we are showing all of the values. So these are some of the properties that you can actually have it with your list box, or I keep saying list box because I had used it in the click view, but these are just the filter pane in the new Qliksense. So edit is here, and say for example you want to change any sort of sorting in case of a multiple fields, you can come over here. And if you want to change the appearance as well, say for example you want to show the title and other related values, you can enable that. And you have the option of specifying title, subtitle and footnote. So these are all the properties that you have that you can change and play around with it. and get the desired output based on the settings given here in the Qliksense filter pane. So that's pretty much about it, the filters in this video, and I will meet you in the new video with a new topic.